your co-author of the book, Mr. Sanjeev Singh Bahga, the other author of the book. Thank you all so much for coming today. As you most of you know that my father has been involved in the beautification and landscaping of this city beautiful for the past 3.5 decades. Pretty much every avenue or tree that has been planted here in Chandigarh has been done under his supervision. We come to call it the city beautiful. He's always felt that landscaping does not get its due importance in the planning of any project. For so many years he's been contributing to the society so that we all can live in a better environment. When he decided to pen down all his thoughts into the book, we were all very excited. And we thank Mr. Bahga, without whose help this book would not have been possible. Without taking further time, I think I'm going to let my father speak a few words about the book, about what went behind, and then I'll pass it to Mr. Bahga, who will say a few words, and then we'll open the floor to questions by the press. Would that be fair? I think that's okay.
And good afternoon to all of you. It is one of the most important elements for the city. City environment actually consists of roads and buildings and sewer and electric supply, water supply. But trees also are one of the important elements which need not be missed at all. We have observed that although in Chandigarh and in New Delhi, these are the two planned cities where tree plantation received a lot of importance, and due to this reason, Chandigarh attained the status of the garden city, because Dr. Nhava had introduced and lots of very outstanding species of trees in Chandigarh. So Chandigarh was lucky in having all the tree plantations in a very planned manner. Delhi also, which was done by Newton 100 years ago, is also tree plantation work done. This is a highly exemplary nature, extremely good in New Delhi also. But we observed that there is a book, it was absolutely needed. It was needed because population is exploding like anything, and therefore urbanization will have to keep pace with it. So there was absolutely need for such a book where the planners and developers of those cities will be able to do tree plantation according to the planned way. So this book has a great significance from that point of view. Now this book also has been given in respect of in respect of so many trees which are used for roadside plantation and plantations in the park, open spaces, and even homes and buildings also. This book also contains design of three parks. One is a big size park, the other is medium, and then small size park. And one of the concepts which has been given about tree plantation of parks is that trees form the background. We created spaces in the park, and trees form the background. And in front of trees, people can plant shrubberies or annuals or whatever. So there will be different kind of park which do not exist at present anywhere. Another one of the very good concepts is about the idea of developing the entire city as a park. People go to the park for relaxation and mingle with nature and become one with it. Trees, if they are used in whole of the city, can take the shape of a park. There is one element which can really, if they are planted extensively in the city. So this is also a new concept which has been presented in the book. Apart from that, we have given methods for raising the plant so that you get 100% result. One of the main items which has been presented in the book is about the fundamental designs which are required to be adopted for tree plantation in the city. If these are adopted, the tree plantation will come out as one of the most outstanding thing in every city. You see, this book has been published in America, and it will be. The publisher has planned to publish it in UK, France, Spain, and then Italy, Australia, so many countries. Because the fundamental principles which has been described in the book are applicable everywhere. Their species of trees may be different, but this applicability is there because we have provided everything which is required, which is needed for planned plantation of the city. These fundamental principles which form a very important part of this book is normally not available. And we read the literature about trees and about landscaping, we've seen lots of books, but it is this kind of conceptual design of the park or the city or the fundamental principles are not available anymore. So the unique part of this book is about all this.
Thank you, Raj. Like I told you earlier, Mr. Bahga was behind compiling this book together, putting it into shape, and doing so much hard work. Yeah, I was so grateful to him. I would like Mr. Bahga to say a few words.
Good evening, friends. Actually, we have been associated with Johl for the last about 25-30 years. We have been working behind the scenes sometimes. In our personal capacity or sometimes in some official capacity, we have been associated with him for the 30 years. When we saw that how much work he has done, we have been persuading him to write a book so that it will be a valuable addition to the literature of landscape architecture, everything. So we have been persuading him for 2-3 years, and again and at the end he agreed to write a book, but with the condition that you must cooperate with us, otherwise he says that I am an old person, I will not be able to handle it properly. So then I agreed. I am architect by profession, so we have written some books on architecture but not on landscaping. So because sir was here, so we were just to help him. My contribution to this was apart from the physical work. I have suggested him that all he was in mind, that was at the scale of city level, town planning scale, that all the trees should be planted in on the roads, on the parks, on the everything. But on a smaller scale, on a micro scale, there was nothing. So then we evolved a system that now we introduced one or two chapters in the book. All the trees can be planted in campuses, small campuses, so that book may be useful to the architects. Architects, small architects who are doing their own practice. We have given some conceptual plans for about 10 or 12 campuses, which we have actually designed, but conceptually sir has planned the tree plantation in it, and we put it in that. So that is the sort of a ready reference for the budding architects, young architects, everybody. So I think it is a very useful book. It's sort of a ready reference book. One can take this book at the table and one can start planting after reading it. Thank you.
Thank you, Bahga-Sahab. You also want to mention specifically the publishers, Mike Falcon. This book is actually available in Amazon.com worldwide. So whoever wants to use it, I think in India it's going to retail around 800 rupees. I'm going to throw the floor open to all of you. If you have any questions, just raise your hand and I'll pass on the mic.
How much time did you take to compile this book or write this book? For how long you've been working on it?
Took me about 3 years to complete this.
Across the city, which are not really very beneficial and also render the soil barren. So what do you have to say about that?
We have described all the outstanding trees with photographs, with write-up in the book, and the trees which are meant for city roads and trees which should be planted in the park or open space or in the building. So it is a complete work done as far as the trees are concerned.
Yeah. And what about the
eucalyptus trees? It will be a very, very useful publication for the architect, The landscape designer and engineers also, those who implement the plantation in the building. The book will be useful.
You are asking about some particular tree?
Eucalyptus.
Eucalyptus.
He wants to know that eucalyptus, how bad is eucalyptus as a tree?
Eucalyptus was planted in sector 17. Because it is a tall tree and goes vertically, it is harmonizes with the height of the building.
Sir, also in PU, Punjab University, we get to see a lot of eucalyptus trees and...
Punjab University has a lot of eucalyptus trees.
And it renders the soil barren.
No, that is not the place for plants. That's not the place. Trees have to be planted according to the structure, texture, and there are other important things. It should be done. Dense plantations, density should be one of the considerations, and diversity also. So that there are not too many mixtures of trees. Scale is very important. Color of flowers is important. Then the place where they are to be planted, whether it is, should be close to the road curb or we push it back away from the roadside. And then pedestrian and vehicle traffic has to be separated. So these are some of the considerations which is got to be given.
There is actually an entire chapter for trees for city roads, chapter 9 and 10, flower tree, trees for cities and public parks in the book.
झूले बेटर हैं कि ट्रीज बेटर हैं?
नहीं, ट्रीज तो नहीं जी, पार्क झूले की बेटर। अब मेरा कहने का मतलब है कि ये जो झूले लगे ना, उसकी दृष्टि से पर्यावरण
आई थिंक अगर आपका क्वेश्चन ये है कि पार्क्स जो चंडीगढ़ के बीच पार्क्स ने उन्हें दे आर आल्सो प्ले ग्राउंड फॉर चिल्ड्रन दे हैव यू नो प्ले इक्विपमेंट फॉर प्लेइंग एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट स्विंग्स एंड अदर थिंग्स सो डू यू फील दैट फॉर इन एनवायरमेंट से इज इट गोइंग टू हैव देम और शुड वी ओनली यूज देम एज पार्क्स एंड लैंडस्केपिंग
फॉर द प्ले ग्राउंड There should be specific design for the playground. Not that every park should become a playground. Parks are actually meant for relaxation of the people and just getting one with nature. They come to enjoy the nature there and relax there. Not for playing football or hockey or anything, or tennis or even cricket. For that purpose, there should be specific ground in the city, planned city, and they are also to be planted, of course, on the side, not on the play area.
He's only talking of
play equipment.
Jhule did it.
They are an integral part of
the swings. Swings, the swings there.
Of course. Actually, this kind of thing is not required, but people in our country, they do fix all these things. There should be some natural kind of thing for play of the children. Not nothing manufactured material there. That is out of place in the park.
Are you planning to write something on that also, or like give a design on how the playground should be, like with the natural swing, what kind of natural swing should be there?
Sir, are you planning to design some playgrounds? Just may bata sakte ki kaise swings hone chahiye, natural swings like you're talking about. So kis tarah ke natural swings hone chahiye? If we leave apart the kind of equipments we swings we have at present in Rose Garden, Rocket.
I think it's a very good question. We can just do that. In the